This video is sponsored by MyHeritage. More about them at the end of the episode. Because you have two parents, and each of those parents has two parents, and so on, your ancestors, parents, grandparents, great-grandparents, and on, should add up pretty fast. In fact, by the time you get just 37 generations back, you would have 137 billion ancestors just in that 37th generation alone. That's more than the 117 billion or so people that have ever lived on Earth, which is impossible. So you must have a lot fewer ancestors than you might think. Hi, I'm Cameron, and this is Minute Earth. To make sense of this, let's say, for example, that I don't know, your parents are first cousins. I know, bear with me for a second. That would mean that two of your grandparents are siblings. And since siblings have the same parents, and therefore the same ancestry, a bunch of these ancestors are duplicates. We can really just count them once. Going back to our 37 generations thing, that's more than 34 billion ancestors we would no longer be counting. That might sound like an extreme example, but more distant relationships, like fourth cousins, which we don't even consider to be that closely related, still hollow out your pyramid. And our family histories are full of lots and lots of inbreeding. That might sound pretty gross to you and me, but mating with relatives hasn't always been frowned upon. Heck, Albert Einstein married his first cousin, and certain royal families actively encouraged inbreeding. But the biggest reason for all of this inbreeding is that, throughout most of human history, we lived in small groups with limited baby-making options, which led to a lot of trees that just don't fork very much. But wait, so far we've been defining your ancestors as everyone you're descended from. If instead we think about an ancestor as someone that actually passed genes on to you, that number is much, much smaller. I know that sounds paradoxical. I mean, you had to get all of your genes from somewhere, so of course they came from your ancestors, but they didn't come from all of your ancestors. Imagine that instead of passing along their genes, people passed along different kinds of candy. To inherit your genome, you close your eyes and you draw an equal number of candies from your mom's bowl and your dad's bowl, each of which contain a mix of everything they got from their ancestors. There are going to be a lot of candies that you don't get. These represent genes that you don't inherit. This is obviously an oversimplification, but I hope you get the idea. You can see how very quickly you might by chance receive fewer or no genes from some ancestors because you received extra from another. Over time, this process means that most of your distant ancestors didn't pass on any DNA to you. If you do the math, which is complicated, you only have a 50% chance of having inherited any DNA at all from a randomly selected ancestor 10 generations back, and a 3% chance of inheriting anything from an ancestor 15 generations back. The majority of your ancestors farther back than that almost certainly didn't pass along any DNA to you. The DNA you did inherit came from only a very small slice of the pyramid of all of your supposed ancestors. So your family tree might be smaller than you think, and your gene pool is even smaller.
Hey Cameron, it's David. I'm just butting in to let you know that my wife and I are definitely not cousins. Well, at least not super close ones. Whew. I just found that out thanks to MyHeritage, which sponsored this video. I typed in the little bit I knew about my relatives, and MyHeritage got to work, finding all sorts of historical documents from their huge library. Like, it found my mom's grandfather Gustav's papers from when he passed through Ellis Island on his way into the US. And also this picture that my dad had never seen before of his grandmother Geta. MyHeritage also finds potential matches, which is how I learned that my great-grandmother Paula regularly used two different spellings of her last name. And as I built up my tree, MyHeritage's instant discoveries function connected me to an already built tree created by a distant relative that added all sorts of new information about my family. They've also got this amazing photo tool that lets you enhance and colorize your old black and white photos. Here's the result when I enhanced and colorized that amazing photo of my great-grandmother. So sign up for a 14-day free trial and enjoy all of the amazing features MyHeritage has to offer. Just scan the QR code here or click the link in the description to get started. Thanks, MyHeritage.